Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, does everyone with pre-diabetes eventually get diabetes? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning and tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. The short answer to this question is no. A diagnosis of prediabetes doesn't mean you will get type 2 diabetes. But whether or not you develop type 2 is totally up to you. You have the power to prevent it, or you have the power to let your diagnosis progress. The American Diabetes Association says that serious lifestyle changes are effective in preventing type 2 diabetes after you've been diagnosed with prediabetes. Your doctor will walk you through what you need to change, but typical recommendations include eat well. A registered dietitian or a certified diabetes educator can help you create a meal plan that's full of good for you and good for your blood glucose level foods. The goal of the meal plan is to control your blood glucose level and keep it in the healthy normal range. Your meal plan will be made just for you, taking into account your overall health, your physical activity, and what you like to eat. Exercise. When you exercise, your body uses more glucose, so exercising can lower your blood glucose level. Also, when you exercise, your body doesn't need as much insulin to transport the glucose. Your body becomes less insulin resistant. Since your body isn't using insulin well when you have prediabetes, a lower insulin resistant level is very good. And of course, there are all the traditional benefits of exercise. It can help you lose weight, keep your heart healthy, make you sleep better, and even improve your mood. The American Diabetes Association recommends at least 150 minutes of moderate activity a week. That's 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week. You can get that through activities such as walking, bike riding, or swimming. Also, lose weight. If you're overweight, you should get started on a weight loss program as soon as you're diagnosed with prediabetes. Losing just 5 to 10% of your weight can significantly reduce the risk of developing type 2. The combination of eating well and exercising more is a great way to lose weight and then maintain your new healthy weight. Metformin. For people who are at very high risk of developing type 2 diabetes after being diagnosed with prediabetes, your doctor may recommend a medication. The American Diabetes Association says that metformin should be the only medication used to prevent type 2. It works by keeping the liver from making more glucose when you don't need it, thereby keeping your blood glucose level in a better range. Your doctor will keep a close watch on your blood glucose levels, monitoring them to make sure that your prediabetes doesn't become type 2. If needed, he or she may suggest adjustments, a different diet, or more exercise to better control your blood glucose levels. Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel so that we can bring you many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.